This is Taylor from Nuts and Bolts Speech and with another PowerPoint trick to help you make happy hour. Using the shapes on your slide as trigger objects for the appear and disappear animations to create professional effects within your presentation. And here in PowerPoint, I have a vector map of the United States and two rectangles up top that I want to use as trigger objects to fire off these animations. And if you want to follow along, you can click the link to download the slide in the description box. As a first step, we want to duplicate our slide, so hit Ctrl+Shift+D on your keyboard to duplicate the slide. On the new slide, we want to select our vector map and hit Ctrl+Shift+G for ungroup, which breaks our vector map into individual shapes that we can move around and format. We then want to select our first group of objects that we want to have color. I'm going to select through Texas, hit Ctrl+G for group. I'll then select the other side, again hit Ctrl+G for group. We then want to color the different groups, so I'm going to select my western region blue rectangle, select the format painter, select this group. I'll do the same with the eastern region, select the format painter, click it, and now we have both groups filled with the correct colors. With the color set, holding shift, I'll select both of the colored groups, hit Ctrl+C to copy, page up, back to our original slide, Ctrl+V to paste, and hit escape. Now before we add any animations to our slide, we want to name both of these rectangles up top that we want to use for our trigger animations using the selection pane. So from the home tab, you can either navigate to the arrange tool, select the selection pane. It's also here on the select, you can see the selection pane, or if you're a keyboard jockey, just hit Alt+F10 on your keyboard to open up the selection pane. And once you have it open, you can see all the different objects here on our slide. You want to navigate and find, in this case it's rectangle 1, our two different trigger objects. I'm going to click in to rename rectangle 1, and I'm going to name it the western region. I'll then select rectangle number 2, double click in, and I'm just going to name this the eastern region. You can name them whatever you like on your own slide. And with the objects renamed, you can then close the selection box by just clicking the X in the upper right-hand corner. So now we want to add our animations, and I'll start here on the western region. So I'll select the blue states. From the animations tab, I'll select the appear animation, and I immediately want to open the trigger dropdown and select on click of, and find my trigger shape, which is the western region, which we just named in the selections pane. We then want to use the add animation dropdown. We also want to add a disappear animation. And again, we want to select from the trigger dropdown on click of, and again, select the western region a second time. So you should have two animations hooked up to this first blue group. I'll do the same thing for the next group. We want an appear animation on click of. This time it's the eastern region. Add animation, disappear animation, trigger on click of, eastern region, like that. With the animations hooked up, you can double check your work by opening up the animations pane, and you should see two different animations hooked up to each of the triggers. The green star represents the appear animation, and the red star represents the disappear animation. From here, if you hit Shift+F5 on your keyboard for presentation mode, you can then test out your different triggers by clicking your trigger objects to see if your objects fill in correctly. So that's how to use your shapes as trigger objects to create professional effects within your presentation. And you can use this trick for just about anything. Pictures, tables, shapes, etc. My only recommendation is not to get too fancy. This is Taylor from Nuts and Bolts Speech Training, and I'll see you at happy hour.